Our planet is feverish. Global warming is threatening our future. In this lecture, causes, effects, and remedies will be shortly described, and the role of the building sector, especially in the East African Community countries, will be examined. Since the beginning of last century, changes have been observed through the climate system. The atmosphere and the ocean have warmed. The extent and volume of snow and ice have diminished, and the sea level has risen. Temperature is going to reach unprecedented values in the last 5 million years. The main cause of temperature rise is the increase in the atmospheric concentration of CO2, whose concentration skyrocketed from 1950 onwards. In 2013, CO2 levels surpassed 400 parts per million for the first time in recorded history. This rise in CO2 shows a remarkably constant relationship with fossil fuel burning. The consequences of the global warming are more and more frequently experienced: hurricanes, floods, landslides, droughts, and fires. Extreme climatic events are an expression of climate change, but they are only one aspect of the problem. At global temperature increase between 1 and 2 degrees C, significant global impacts on ecosystems and water resources are likely. And from 2.5 degrees C upwards, negative impacts on global food production are also likely, with dramatic consequences on the increasing world population. The picture shows some of the impacts related to specific and increasing temperature. In December 2015, to cope with the global warming was signed by almost all the countries in the world the Paris Agreement, committing all these countries to hold the global average temperature to well below 2 degrees C above the pre-industrial levels, and to pursue efforts to limit the temperature increase to 1.5 degrees C above pre-industrial levels. To reach the 2 degrees C target, the emissions in 2015 should be reduced by 50% with reference to those in 1990. Developed countries will have to reduce them by 85%, and developing countries should not increase them, in spite of their hopefully expected development. Developing countries are going to play a decisive role in the future world CO2 emissions scenario as a consequence of their economic development. Putting it in another way, to achieve the 2 degrees C target, world greenhouse gas emissions should be reduced to 2 tons of CO2 equivalent per capita in 2050, with 2 billion people more. For East African Community countries, the challenge is economic growth with greenhouse gas emission reduction. In 2010, the building sector of the whole world was responsible for 25% of total GHG emissions deriving from fossil fuel combustion, second only to the industrial sector. In East African Community countries, the building sector takes the highest share of energy consumption, 65% in Kenya, 74% in Tanzania, 83% in Uganda. This is due mainly to the inefficient use of energy for cooking, lighting, hot water production, and air conditioning. Air conditioning, of course, only in wealthy homes and commercial buildings. Improving the quality of life, this share will diminish, approaching to that of developed countries, but the absolute value of the greenhouse gas emissions will increase. This increase will be enhanced by the fact that the expected improvement of living conditions will lead to a shift from biomass, which is carbon neutral, to fossil fuels. But this does not tell the full story. We have to consider also the energy needed for production of building materials, the so-called embodied energy, which becomes embodied emissions if the CO2 produced is taken into account. The impact on world emissions of construction materials is not negligible. It weighs for more than 12%, mainly due to cement and steel. The picture is exacerbated by a worrying trend. Modern buildings in East African community countries are replicas of buildings designed for Western world, where climate is cold or temperate, and do not take into consideration the differences in climate, so becoming energy voracious. But the main reason of the expected increase of energy consumption and thus of CO2 emissions in the East African community is due to the population increase, which almost doubled from now to 2050. This increase, combined with the economic growth, will cause a sharp increase of the number of buildings. If all these new buildings will be as energy consuming as the present ones, it will be impossible to meet the 2 degrees target. While in Europe it is expected that in the year 2050 something like 25-30% of the building stock will have been built between now and that date, in developing countries the figure can be estimated close to 75%. The challenge is unprecedented and it requires by now a radical transformation of the ways to design and build. The reduction of CO2 emissions by reducing energy consumption is the top priority that the construction industry has to face. Especially the construction industry of the East African community, with a large amount of buildings that are being built and will be built next year, is in the front row.